Hey everybody, welcome to Three Dudes and Their Submissives. This is the Free-to-Play Friday version of the show. Today we'll be playing Warframe. Hello.
How y'all doing?
Hey everybody, my name is OJ. In the top right, as normal, you have Drawl. In the bottom left, Hobo.
Hobo? Where the hell? Hobo, you there?
I don't know.
Hey, Hobo. Hobo. Oh, there he is.
His cardboard box.
There's Hobo. How you doing, Hobo? That's the buddy.
Bottom right, we have our friend Fallen Decay, a follower of the stream. On the right middle, in the, what's his name? Peter Brady position, we have Buffalo, our friend that we had last week. On the, who would that be? That would be Jan Brady. Jan Brady, we have our resident fighting game expert, Mr. Fly Swatter. No, Fly Watcher. Fly something.
Fly Walker.
Fly Walker.
Right.
We have Fly Walker, who is also our Warframe expert. So he's going to be leading us through our Free-to-Play Friday, because I think most of us haven't even played this fun game before.
Glad to be here.
Glad to have you guys here. So, Flywalker, can you just give us a brief overview of Warframe, launch us in the first instance, tell us what the fuck is going on in this thing?
Alright, so WTF is Warframe, huh? I'm sorry, bad trade. Let's see, Warframe is a free-to-play MMO in which you can play as basically ninjas with guns in space. And what you do is you fight these people. They can be the Grineer, the Corpus, or the Infested. Grineer being the main enemies in the game, the Corpus and Infested being sides. Infested, I think the Flood, basically from Halo 3, if you've thought of that before.
Alright.
Corpus are like mechanical and robotic peoples, and Grineer are basic soldiers. So today, we get the party set up. We're going to be going to Terminus and Mercury. This is the first planet in the game that you can have access to. Are we all ready?
I'm ready. So, let's check this out.
Because we have so many guests, this is our first time actually doing this. Obviously, Hobo isn't here tonight for whatever reason he has. We're going to be swapping players out in and out through the time. That way we get everybody in. First up will be myself, Draw, Sweet Creeper, Kill My Ass, aka Fallen Decay, and Flywalker.
Okay.
Peter Brady gets thrown out once again. Because who the fuck doesn't hate Peter Brady? We all
Oops,
do.
That was bad.
Yeah.
Alright, let's start. So to start, you all click on the mission you want to enter. This Terminus.
Okay.
You get Samurai on the top, in the middle there.
Yeah, I'm not seeing the map.
It's right there, motherfucker. Click the bottom thing.
Which one are we going to?
Terminus.
Terminus is in the middle of the screen.
Mercury?
There we go.
Click Terminus, you dumb
Shut
motherfucker!
Shut up! Alright, I'm blind!
You're
Fuck!
Retarded.
You know what? Fuck you guys.
Alright, 5 seconds.
Fuck you. No. Fuck you. Get my hands warmed up.
Don't make me come in this bitch like a wrecking ball.
I'ma beat your bitch like it owes me money. By your bitch, I mean your tiny little dick.
Yeah, okay.
There's a large platoon of Grineer Marines stationed on this vessel.
Think about it.
Alright, so we are in Terminus Mercury.
You're still in the clear. No detection from enemy sensors.
Not detected all. We're gonna get
detected. Parkour and shit. Okay.
This is one of the main Grineer tile sets. This is one of the ship. Level 1.
Sounds good.
I forget. How do you melee again?
Melee is
Oh yeah, it is.
Oh shit! I used my ability when I hit middle mouse button. The buttons are different. I don't like it.
Middle mouse button. My scroll up and down. Middle mouse button.
Oh no, you saw my face, Raspberry. You've seen my face. Fuck. Now you won't ever take me, LeBron.
Okay, so... I got to play this game back when it very first came out, like when it very first started, and I thought the game was pretty interesting.
Yeah, it was pretty fun back then.
And I stopped playing because, you know, it was a closed beta, and normally they wipe closed betas, but they didn't. I still have all my stuff in there. Everything I have is actually from the closed beta.
Oh, really? Well, so you got the best.
Unfortunately for me, you know, I went to go verify game cache in Steam, and I'm apparently missing 3 gigs of data.
It's going to download the original files that aren't updated on the updated version. So you're going to download the whole game, and then you're going to have to update it again, the entire thing.
Son of a bitch.
Dude, you got Peter Brady. You got Peter Brady, sir.
Yeah, I did.
Anyway, guys.
I mean, you actually got to shoot anything. You just run around killing everything. How about you let us kill something? Damn it!
I'm so sorry.
Jeez.
We should just sit in the back.
I mean, we were gonna get carried, but damn!
First up, guys, I got an article from CNET about the Xbox One and the PS4 shock. About facial recognition technology. Who's gonna have the better technology? And the list of similarities between the Xbox One and the PlayStation 4 is long. Both systems release the blah blah blah. One big difference, above Connect, who gives a shit? Jesus Christ. Anyway, the point is, both the PS4 and the Xbox One are harping on facial recognition technology. My question to you guys is, who gives a fuck about facial recognition technology? Make a goddamn game that's good.
Well,
that was more of a statement.
Warframe already, so I won't see PS4. Like, facial recognition, like, who wants to see me fat? Come on.
Yeah, that's my question, right? Like, who the fuck cares about what someone looks like when they're playing the game? You're trying to watch the game. Leave the webcams to cam whores and chatterbait. Do you need facial recognition? What are you gaining from that?
Yeah, I still love the whole part.
Password?
Conception. I could give a shit about facial recognition. There's all kinds of stuff that's starting to use it, but why the fuck does a console need it?
Why is that listed as a fucking feature on a gaming console is my question. Like, what the fuck? Like, who
cares? But it'll recognize your face. It'll recognize your face, and then it'll load your profile. You won't have to hit any buttons, because it's not... I want to say it's convenience, but it's just going to make gamers that are already lazy even lazier.
How many people have multiple accounts on their fucking console in the first place? I feel like that's a minor feature.
It's my brother. He has 4 kids, and it's him and his wife, and every last one of them have their own account.
Why?
You know, when they have their own profile, it loads all their it loads different save files so they don't overwrite each other's saves in their games.
The background color?
It also loads different save files.
For example, if you're playing COD, right, and then your kid wants to play it, so you're like, okay, little Johnny, go ahead and play COD, and he kills your KD, and you're now like 0.01.
You're playing Skyrim and everybody else wants to play Skyrim, but someone starts a new save and it wipes out your old one, and you were, you know, an hour from beating the game or something, and you got to play through the whole game because your save got erased. That's one of the reasons.
Back in the day when it was, you know, a cartridge game that only had one save file. Come on now.
I don't like how they're
doing Prime next.
Okay, then let's do something. I'll keep changing up my frames as we go along, since I have a couple. I think next I'll go with Rhino because...
I'm using the, Vault? Yeah? Yeah? I think that's what I'm using.
I don't even know what I'm using. I have fun, though. I'm jumping
up and
down.
We'll play a couple more missions, and I'll go through and show some of the inventory and all that stuff.
Okay, sounds good.
Steam... was about 2 years ago now, they actually started putting free-to-play games aside from TF2, they actually started putting a lot of free-to-play games on Steam, and more are getting added. This game was added, 6 months ago? Maybe less than that?
It's been on there longer than that.
How many of you have actually played other free-to-play games just through Steam?
Me.
I have, yeah.
Say how many? Like...
Six? Seven?
Three or so.
And would you have played them if they weren't on Steam?
I've played most without Steam.
Okay. I probably would have.
I usually check stuff out when it comes out on Steam, but I have played free-to-play games not using Steam. But I've also, like, in the case of Vindictus, I played it a bunch, then stopped playing, but played it more when it came on Steam. So.
I mean, do you think there's people that won't play a free-to-play game until it's on Steam? Or that they've never heard of it until they added it to Steam?
I think it's mainly about, like, getting the word out for the game. I'm not sure about it. So Steam is faster download.
Doesn't necessarily mean faster download. It's just a more easily acceptable and accessible download.
Well, it's credibility, too. If you get on the Steam page, there is a certain allure and credibility to that.
I'm a big supporter of those Greenlight games as well.
Same here.
Do you think Greenlight works? I mean, there's a lot of people that think Greenlight doesn't work.
I mean, Greenlight does what it has to do. Like, it just gets the word out for the different developers to get their game out.
Yeah, it gets the game out. Like, the game Risk of Rain was Greenlight.
Yeah, the game Let's Spin the Orphanage was also Greenlight. I mean, there's just as much trash on Greenlight as there is good stuff, but that's not to say the same stuff doesn't happen with AAA releases, you know? Mm-hmm. Plenty of shit AAA releases.
I mean, there's been a couple games that I never heard of, and I was like, oh wow, it's on Steam, I'm gonna try that game. Or there's other games where like, I really don't want to play it, but then they added it to Steam, and I was like, you know what, I'm gonna try it.
I'd rather have a game, from Greenlight be, you know, relatively good compared to, you know, some of the stuff that have, you know, multi-billion dollar budgets or million dollar budgets and are still utter shit.
Yeah.
They got waypoints down waiting
too,
on someone.
Steam gives you a bit of tracking on your purchases too. Like, it saves it, you know.
Yeah.
You know, we have better reference than an independent website, which may or may not be as reliable or trustworthy as Steam is. If I buy something on Steam, I trust that it's a safe purchase. Some guy's website, I don't know. Cash shops.
Looking for a war tune.
Yeah.
And yeah, as for those things, like, you deserve your wishes.
Have you ever played a game that, you know, you're just like, wow, that game looks great, but it was a pay-to-play game, and you played it once it went free-to-play, and you still play it now? Are there any games like that for you guys?
There was one for a while, yeah.
What game was that?
And I'm utterly ashamed of it, but EverQuest.
EverQuest. Ugh. EverQuest 1?
The original EverQuest.
Christ.
Yeah, I tried playing that, actually, when they added it to Steam and it went free-to-play, and I got to the character creation, and when I realized I still had to actually type, like, slash talk to talk to an NPC, you know, actually do the slash commands and that kind of stuff, I was like, no, I can't do that. I couldn't do it.
You don't have to do the slash commands, it's just changing it if you're in a different channel.
It's, you know, it was one thing back then because it was new and it was shiny to do that, you know, it's like a cool kind of mechanic, but it was driving me nuts. So I was like, nope, I'm going to pass.
Well, what about games that start as pay to play and then
that's
more
what I'm talking. That's what we're talking
games.
About.
Oh man, like fucking, I've got...
EverQuest was one of them.
Dungeonland, they
fucked
me. I
played EverQuest from launch in 98 till about 2007.
Yeah, and there's games like Dungeonland. Dungeonland and like Forge, those games were like some of them were actually Kickstarter games. And then people Kickstarted or people bought the game, 4-packs of the game for their friends, and then now they're making the games free to play. And there's content in those games, whether they're skins or whatever the case may be, that you don't get access to, even though you already own the game, that you still have to pay for if you want to play it, even though you already own the game. Right. But now, everything that you did own is available to people who are now free to play.
Yeah, EverQuest is something similar to that.
Dick move.
They have multiple levels of free to play. Like, your basic free-to-play is bronze. You have, I think it's like 2 character slots. Access to, I think, I think they made it so you have access to certain classes. They may have made it to all of them, I can't remember. But then you pay just a single flat $5 and you upgrade to silver, which gives you, I think, 2 more character slots, extra stuff, access to some other things that you wouldn't normally have on bronze. But then you have, you know, your monthly subscriptions, which are, you know, the gold subscription, and you have access to everything.
Well, yeah. I mean, like, to give a really bad example, fucking, there was Gotham City Impostors launched as a pay-to-play game, $15 a copy, with games for Windows Live. Then, within a couple of weeks, they had $200 worth of DLC on the store, and within 3 months, they patched the game to be a free-to-play game with Steamworks instead of games.
It was longer than 3 months, but...
It was not very long, though. I don't know how long it was. I stand corrected.
I mean, it was about 3 months after you got the game, but that the game was out about 4 months before you got it.
So, like...
Within a year.
Yeah, it went free-to-play within a year. So did Dungeonland.
Yeah.
And Forged. And Forged did it, too.
But when a game...
Forged is broken on watch, too.
I'm okay with games that are buy-to-play, like Guild Wars.
Guild Wars, that's one of them. Secret World started as a buy-to-play, or a
pay-to-play
with subscription, and now it's buy-to-play. And I personally think that game is great.
I love buy-to-play games.
Buy-to-play is great.
Guild Wars 2.
Yeah.
Mainly because Guild Wars 1, it had this, I don't know what it was about it, but it just had this thing that worked. Max level 20, you could get there in like 3 hours, and then it was hours of fun and multi-classing and stuff of that sort up to then.
Sounds fun.
Yeah, and Guild Wars 2, unfortunately, they got rid of multi-classing, and now max level is 80, and I got it at launch. My highest level is like a 60.
I got the game at launch, too, and I grinded 2 characters and like both in a week at a time, max level.
Yeah, I can't stand it. I can't do it. Like, I can't. To me, it's too much of a grind in order to get to 80, and I can't enjoy the game.
It was I grinded Necro and Ranger for my 2 characters.
And I love the Necromancer and Ranger in Guild Wars 1. They were my favorite characters. And sadly enough, when I made, you know, my Necromancer in Guild Wars 2, I was a Minion Master in Guild Wars 1. You know, army of 30 or so minions following me around.
Yeah.
I couldn't do that.
Guild Wars 1, I played a Ritualist, and that class isn't in the game at all.
Yeah, they're saving classes like that for expansions.
Of course.
Because Ritualist was originally in factions.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it was the first expansion. Now, people seem to have a strong opinion of free-to-play games. Some people think they don't work, some people think they're the greatest thing ever, and most of the people that I think free-to-play games are the greatest thing ever are people who generally are also really short on, or have no budget, or are very limited on budget. Now,
I'm okay
there's...
with free-to-play games. As long as they're not pay-to-win.
There's multiple types of free-to-play models. See, there's premium games, or freemium games, that where you get a general base amount of content. Say, like, Champions Online. You get access to the actual, like, levels of the game, but you don't get all of the skills and classes. You don't get a freeform character, which means freeform is you can build anything, any of the powers or abilities in the game you can use. Where if you're a free-to-play version of the game, where the free-to-play version of the game, you're limited to an archetype. Where you're a melee blaster, or you're a melee character that uses axes, or you're a blaster that uses fireballs. It's a very generic character.
But you can still spend money to get access to other archetypes. And
yes, you
abilities.
Can. Where if you were to pay for a subscription for the game, you would have access to everything while you are paying a subscription.
Regardless.
Then there are free-to-play games, which are, in my opinion, the buy-to-play games, which I think EverQuest 2 is a buy-to-play game, because you can buy raid gear from the store, and that is just ridiculous. You should never be able to do that in a free-to-play game.
I consider those ones like that pay-to-win game.
And then they don't add free content either. When they add content, they add them as add-on packs or expansions that you have to pay for. That is the absolute shittiest free-to-play model. But then you get games like Terra and Rift, where you get everything in the game available to you to play, except for like skins or mounts.
I mean, I'm okay with that.
And you still get mounts in the game, but
yeah,
you just don't get the really ridiculous looking ones. But their function is still the same.
I mean, it's just like with the Guild Wars 2 auction. It's not auction house, but a gem store. I think it's called. I can't remember. Their store, they have items that just change the look of items, but you still retain the stats of what they are. Or you pay money and you get access to, some items that allow you to harvest materials more efficiently.
Door's locked. Yeah.
You guys okay?
Yeah.
Yeah,
I don't know. I think the idea of free-to-play is a great idea, but when you start applying it to companies that want to make money, you start to have things like Saints Row 4 has skin content that is in addition to a season pass. Or Borderlands 2 has new skins that are only out, that are exclusive, that are not in the season pass and cost $2 or $3, and there's dozens of them. I think that's just a toxic bastardization of what free-to-play is, and is really a result of free-to-play games being existing.
I'm okay with that. Like, as long as the DLCs are included, like the actual missions and such are included in the season pass. Up to a certain point, because I mean, sometimes the game will do so well and they'll amend, putting more funds into more DLC.
But are skins really DLC? I mean, that just seems like 10 years ago, that shit would just be in the game.
A lot of times they take suggestions from the community and end up creating, stuff like that.
Right.
So, I mean, skins and such that don't really change the play of a game at, a buck or two per, I don't really have a problem with, because, those $2 per, let's say, a million people out there want to get that skin. I know, that's still, 2 million?
That's a lot of money to be profiting off of a non-game-changing cosmetic item for a game that only has co-op. I don't know. I think that's just predatory. I think that's a dick move.
If people are willing to pay it, companies are still. So I mean, it's the American dream, taking a fool their money.
I guess that's one way of looking at it. I don't know, man. I think it's shady businesses. But we're seeing more. I think we're starting to see less of it.
Like, I would say shady business for me would be a game company saying, yeah, we're going to be releasing so much DLC and selling a season pass, but only putting out, like, one DLC every, like, year and a half. Like, or longer. When a game comes out and has, a season pass, I expect DLC to be relatively, to keep interest in a game, not once interest is gone to bring back interest by trying to release DLC after the fact.
I'm down, yo.
Or shall I say, like, Peter Mullen knew Lion Head when he was still there. And all those fucking lies he would talk about with the Fable games.
Well, Peter Molyneux's delightfully insane,
Delightfully insane, huh?
But I mean, every time he would talk all this glorious stuff, people would go out and buy the game, get home, and be fucking disappointed.
Like, did you hear about what he wanted to do with the Ultimate DLC experiment?
Yes.
With the box, you heard about this?
Yes.
Has anyone not heard of this?
Me.
Basically, Peter Molyneux wanted to make a Minecraft-like game where there's a giant box. And each layer of the box is a different kind of pick to take out it. And it would be a community game. So it'd be like a Minecraft server with a giant box. And the first level of the box would just be dirt. Anybody could pick the dirt away. It was completely free. The next level would be rock. And rock would be $5 for a pick. And as many people could pay that $5 to pick the rock. And then the next level would be fucking soot. And soot would require a $10 pick. And so on and so forth, until you get to the final layer, which is a $10,000 layer of rock that only, that you have to pay a $10,000 fee to get the rock. And he wanted to see how, and it would be an experiment in human curiosity. Who would be willing to pay $10,000 just to find out what was on the other side?
And like I said, it's just like how on iTunes for the longest time there was an app that cost like
a million something dollars,
like a million dollars just to have it on your phone.
That's genius. Why the fuck did I do that?
It did nothing.
I don't care. I would have sold it.
Yeah, I know. And Apple eventually removed it, but it was there.
Apple's stupid. Then they should have left that shit on there.
But I mean,
that
would
make it more worthwhile.
Genius. I mean, there was something like, hold on, let me see if I can find out how many people bought that app.
I would assume at least a dozen, if not a couple hundred. Those TF2 rings that cost $200 and they're just an engagement ring, an in-game cosmetic item, they sell like hundreds of those a day.
Yeah.
Hundreds, if not more.
And that's why free-to-play is a brilliant. What did he say? Predatory marketing?
I call it predatory.
And I know people like Noobophile from the own community. He'll play a game. He didn't give a shit if it's free to play. And if it has a pack, whether or not he might play the game for an hour and never play it again. But if it has a DLC pack that he can buy and get content in that might put him ahead, he'll buy it.
I just think the idea of free-to-play is not that the game is free, but that you're tricking people into paying more money.
Okay,
it's
no,
kind of
it,
like... No.
Oh, sorry about that. The name okay. of the name of the app was I Am Rich, and it was... essentially $1,000. It did absolutely nothing. And it's controversial, and after a day or so, Apple pulled it from the App Store, but not before the developer sold 8 copies.
Okay. Give me a second.
That's fucking awesome.
People are stupid. Oh my god.
Okay,
that's
so.
Brilliant.
So,
are you serious?
Just a quick side whatever here. I'm going to show some of this stuff off as soon as I can find it. Where's the arsenal? There it is. Okay, so. This game is basic. Like the best way for me to describe Warframe. I don't know if you guys have ever played games like Dragonica or actually Vindictus. I personally think this game is sci-fi Vindictus. That's what it feels like.
I personally believe Vindictus is better.
Well, I'm not talking about what's better. I'm just saying, like, the game that I think it can most relate to.
I find the movie controlling Vindictus a lot more entertaining than Warframe.
Is that a fucking contest, asshole?
The game is more similar to Vindictus than any other games. That's it. But
yeah.
you got loot, you got equipment, you got upgrades. So my Warframe is the Vault. Now, you get upgrades, mods you loot in the game. I don't know if they've ever added to where you can craft them or not. But see, right now I have speed, shock, rush. Like, some of them are actually activated abilities, other ones are just passive stats.
It's really
whatever.
Hurt.
Right. And then I think that they call them potatoes, whatever they upgrade, the amount of, upgrade slots or whatever you have available in your suit at the time, which is this number right here. I think they're Orokin reactors or something like that is what they're called, but people call them potatoes. Potato.
Yeah.
Potato.
Weapons,
potato is the new thing.
Warframes themselves, as far as I remember, they actually gain experience while using them. similar to the game Spiral Knights, where all your equipment leveled.
You level up while you use them, and that opens up more energy for adding new mods into them to make them stronger.
Then the game has a crafting system.
Harder, better, faster, and stronger.
You can loot crafting materials and recipes, chassis, blueprints, whatever, and you craft shit. I mean, that's about it. I mean, there's... I think they've added clan dojos, so... can you tell me what the benefit of a clan dojo is?
Oh, well, you know, don't you go to the clan dojo?
One person at a time.
Well, I just got into one, and earlier they have research, which gives clan-based weapons and items, and it has a dueling area, obstacle course, trading area.
So it's kind of like a guild hall?
Pretty much.
And it allows you to craft and stuff like that, like stuff that you didn't have before? Research?
Once the guild items get crafted, everyone in the guild can get that item.
Nice. Yeah, see, that's
cool.
You get
the blueprint for it so you can craft it.
So there's a reason to actually be in a clan and get a dojo. Yeah. There's a lot of benefits to that. That's kind of cool.
And that's just been added in the last patch, I think.
Dojos have been in a while. I think they might have reworked them, though. I know they just added trading, though. That I don't think that was in the game
trading
before.
Trading is new. I have not tried that yet.
Trading is in the last patch.
Now, the game does have an item wall. I think it's platinum. And I believe you can actually buy weapons and armor through there, though you won't be able to use them if you're not the right level. And I think some of them you can get recipes for in-game. I don't know if you can get all of them in-game or not. But I believe you can get most of it in-game by looting. Then they'll do random events where if you play and kill a certain amount of mobs during an event, you'll actually get stuff that you can only get at that time period by doing the event. I know they've given out a couple things like that. They're usually just slightly or different skin versions of a gun that's already in the game. There's usually not a big upgraded difference. Sometimes
like the prime weapons.
Sometimes they are.
Well, those include the Wraiths and the Vandals. For instance, we have the Breton Vandal, the Snetron Vandal, the Lato Vandal, the Machete Wraith, and the Strun Wraith so far.
Buffalo, were you able to get in the game yet?
Nope.
Okay.
Like I said, I mean, you're welcome to just tell me to fuck off.
No, you're here.
This turn is...
I'll tell you to fuck some stuff.
Alright, how do I go back to the...
Later. When everyone else is gone.
How do
we get back to the mission choosing?
Yeah, right?
Yeah, just hit exit and you'll get back to it.
I don't see exit. There's no exit. Escape. Right, click that. There we go. Exit.
Just escape.
Yeah. Okay. Let's do the next mission. It's what, Elon? I think that's the next one?
Yeah.
What planet is this on? I'm lost.
Okay, let's get us another, topic going.
Oh, I got it. I just don't know how to click the thing. I want to click the other thing for you guys.
So, let's all talk about how much of a dick Hobo is for not showing up.
No.
I don't know him, but
that's what we call him boring.
You guys.
I don't know what... I'm on the planet screen. How do I click into a thing?
Just click on
search for Mercury and click on it.
If you click zoom out the bottom, you click Mercury, and then you click the planet.
There we go. Elon. There we go. Anyway, guys, I think you'll enjoy this one. This should be funny. Very funny. Senator takes aim at sick video game based on Sandy Hook Massacre, a sick online video game that has players reenacting last year's horrific murders of schoolchildren in Sandy Hook, Connecticut, has outraged Senator Richard Blumenthal, calling for a ban. Quote, the slaying of sick elementary, end quote, allows a player to simulate a massacre that left 20 first graders and 7 adults dead, purportedly created by Ryan Jake Lambornan, an American-born gaming geek who lives in Australia. The crude game allows a player to collect a loaded gun and shoot his mother before going on a rampage at a school. Several websites have taken the game down, but Blumenthal, the Democratic senator who was previously Connecticut's attorney general, wanted to sit off the web altogether.
Yeah, unfortunately, once something's out there on the internet, it's up out there forever.
Yeah, pretty much. It's always.
Well, I think the scarier thing is you have a senator demanding to ban speech. Dare I say, ban art? Because it's offensive. You can't have that. Can you?
Well, there's still a lot of people that don't think video game is art.
Well, they're wrong. So I don't think there's a debate there. They're just wrong.
It's not that it's a game, it's the content that matters. Like, you know, some dude shot up a bunch of kids, everybody that's really...
I mean, it is pretty screwed up that someone would make a video game about that, but...
It's a dick move. I'm not saying it's a nice thing to do.
But I mean, at the same time, every time something bad ever happens in the news, every time someone gets shot or someone goes on a killing spree or whatever, it's always the fault of a video game anymore. It's a load of shit.
Well, they have a screenshot of the game, and it looks like a fucking, like... 2D platformer type game anyway, which is just ironic because it's like, it's basically a bunch of blocks shooting other blocks, right? And you're just calling it Sandy Hook Shooter. So what difference does it fucking make?
They can just have them rename it or something, I don't know.
But should they have to? I mean, I don't know. I think it's an iffy area to have a senator like getting pissed off about what some guy does in Australia with his fucking free time. If the website takes down for their fruition. Oh, sorry, go ahead.
Like, if it's not within... Like, if it's not a domestic issue, then it shouldn't be really that big of a deal. I mean, it's the internet. It's still
bad, right?
But, like, it's just...
People do fucked up shit, make fucked up gifts on, like, 4chan all the time. Like, who cares if the guy made a fucking web game that none of us had ever heard of, and none of us would have heard of until he starts reporting on it.
Right.
This guy's gonna be...
Hardly anyone had probably heard of it until they're like, oh, well, there's this game, and now everyone knows about it because this guy threw it out there and was angry about it in the first place.
It's a big deal to anyone who cares about free speech. I think it's a big deal because now you got a senator saying... He wants it wiped from the internet. Like, what kind of thing is that to say? That's insane.
As soon as you allow that to happen, that's the first step to fucking the machines taking over. Like,
we're missing somebody.
Deus Ex. Deus Ex. The whole series of Deus Ex is going to become real. People hacking into each other's brains. The whole skin chip put in, and there's the. You gotta draw a limit somewhere.
I'm missing somebody and I'm scared, and where is he?
Trying to catch up.
I'm saving. I'm sorry. We left you. I'm so used to the fast space. I forgot I was playing with those.
I know, right?
You can run by holding shift, but don't let, like, hit it a little bit, then let off. Hit a little bit and let off. You still get the boost, and you can recharge, and it'll recharge while you're still sprinting if you do it right.
Pretty much the fast way of moving around is shift control.
Yeah, the slide. You're moving faster, and you're recharging.
Yeah.
Okay, so creeper, just, you know, stay next to me so you don't.
I'm toasty.
I'm both as well sometimes.
The other thing is, like, people make fucked up video games all the time. It's just he happened to title this one Sandy Hook Shooter. If it had been titled, I don't know, Jario, the story of the guy who likes to shoot things.
Jario.
Yeah, Jario, the guy who just shoots shit on a platform.
I mean,
no one would give a fuck. He just titled it something offensive. If he had did the exact same plot and just titled it, I don't know, anything else, no one would care. It's so stupid that people would give a fuck of a distasteful title.
Well, yeah, this was pretty bad, but let's say this guy wants to go ahead and just say, what's the title of this game again? Sandy Hook Massacre?
Yeah, hold on, I'll give you the exact title here.
Well, that's just
the Slaying of Sandy
Mayhem.
Hook Elementary. The Slaying of Sandy Hook Elementary is the official title.
Slaying of Sandy... Okay, let's just say the Slaying to the Zimmerman Saga or something like that, and you know, you just cheer the Trayvon Martin, like, people will get butthurt about it.
Yeah, but I mean, if you just had a game where a guy stalks a kid and then shoots the kid, or something to that effect, and you just called it
kind of game. I don't know.
Slayer. Yeah, exactly. They just call it The Slaying. Instead of calling it The Slaying of Trayvon Martin, all of a sudden everyone would be like, oh man, that's so innovative. Well, that's art. Just like Gone Home.
Just like Gone Home.
Nah, man, that would be still pretty fucked up, in my opinion. Like, it can be done, just too soon. Too soon.
Feels like the Titanic or something.
It's kind of like the shit where, you know, the whole astronauts dying, seven up, seven down.
Wow. That's fucked up.
Alright. What are
you guys thinking about this so far? This whole war thing. I like the movement system a lot. The movement's
really cool. Improved it greatly. Added the parkour. I was so happy when they added running on walls and stuff. It was pretty fun.
Yeah.
Now, this game was actually made supposedly like a successor or whatever, like hundreds of years or something like that later to the game called Dark Sector. And the main character in that game's name was Tenno.
Dark Sector.
Yeah, that's what I said. Dark Sector.
It cut off, I'm sorry.
Now, these guys, they've also made most recent Star Trek game. The co-op action-adventure game. I believe they also did one, like, I could be wrong, but I think they also worked on one of the Bioshock 2 game modes.
That's what I've heard.
And they also made Darkness 2.
Darkness 2 is pretty badass. I liked it a lot.
There you go. You guys got it?
Okay, there we go. So, that was a team known for being very innovative, and the devs are actually very, very familiar with the, fan base and the player base in general, because they have these live streams. So when the game was still in its early development stages, they'd always have a live stream saying, hey, what's up, we're doing this, we're doing that, the next update will have X and Y, this new weapon, these new frames, our lives are like this, and so fun. Hey, it's some free platinum. First raffle ticket thing there, so everybody was happy about it, so hey, these devs are cool, I support them, and more people came in, and overall a very warm and happy community for the most part.
Now, I'm going to do a couple things. If you're watching currently, I am running the game on low settings. Now, that is amazing if you're actually seeing how it looks. It's better than some games on high that are still releasing, which is kind of sad. I'm going to actually change the settings of the game to a higher settings just so you can kind of see what it looks like. But I will have to change it back.
Did you turn on the multi-thread rendering?
Oh yeah.
Yes. This game looks so beautiful. This is like the one game I can play in the highest settings in my whole arsenal. I'm running crap top i7. It's whatever.
Oop.
This looks amazing.
Yeah, okay. The textures are... I mean, some of these textures are fantastic.
And when there's absolutely no lag at all. Like, just try playing solo, because solo you get the best frame rate.
Alright, well, I changed everything to high. Now, the biggest change you'll see is the stuff like in the atmosphere, like particles, bullets, physics. Textures change a little bit. They change more based off of their environments around them when you have those settings on high. They don't necessarily change so much when they're just regular. Okay, hitting it.
Dynamics are pretty cool. Yeah, we gotta go over there. So let's talk about your frames, guys. What are you running?
I don't actually know.
I'm getting at least 60 FPS.
It's 29 FPS on high, but I was getting 60 when I had it on low.
But I have a decent rig, so
I'm using a Mac, a pre-built Mac. That's...
I'm getting about 40.
But I'm going to change it back to low. I just wanted to show you some of this because it does kind of kill the stream quality. I just, you know, some people care about graphics, so it's just something I feel like I should show. I'm going to do something a little... well, anyone who's been watching the our Twitch streams through the last couple days or week or so, we've actually been giving away games to our followers, and when we reach a certain amount of people, we'll give a game away in the chat for Steam. Well, I'm actually going to do one as after the stream ends today. I'm going to give a game away in chat. So,
oh, nice.
If you are here in chat, stick around after the video ends, especially if you want to get a game. However, the only way you can receive the game is if you are a follower.
Click that follow button.
So hit that follow button. I do this every time we play a game around the last 10 minutes, so we're gonna get to that part now. We will ask each person their opinion of the game and what you would rate the game. Now, you don't have to give it a number, you know, if you're against a number rating system, just, you know, say whatever. But I'm gonna go by each person one by one, and you'll give your opinion of the game. You know, if you want to rate it, you can rate it.
We'll start.
Alright, Sweet Creeper will go first.
I dig the movement system. I'm a sucker for parkour. Okay. It's got great textures, great, doesn't lag, which is good. Solid party system. Lots of upgrades, lots of levels. I'm very impressed with it. Especially if you're looking for a free-to-play shooter type game, which I don't think there are enough of yet. So I'm a pretty, I would definitely recommend people check this game out. If I had to rank it, I'd rank it a nice love tap on a hot lover's ass.
I think that's a pretty good rating. Yeah, that's pretty good.
I like that.
Okay, let's go with our unfortunate Buffalo, who wasn't actually able to play with us today. What is your rating, your opinion of this game?
Wait, so what was the question? Sorry, I was reading.
Really? You know what? I'm gonna slap a bitch.
I was getting bored.
I'm gonna do you like I do my dong when it pisses me off, alright?
Alright, just tell us that.
What is your opinion? What is your rating of Warframe?
3.5 dongs.
3.5 dongs. Out of how many?
Out of how many dongs?
5 dongs.
Out of 5. That's pretty good. Now, are these, you know, the size matters. Don't let anyone lie to you. So what size dongs are we talking about?
Are these black dongs or are these tiny Asian dongs?
Tiny Asian dongs. I mean, come on.
Oh.
You can fit more in.
You can fit more in, right? Alrighty.
Alright.
It's a fun game, but it gets repetitive and boring rather quickly. I can really only play it for maybe like an hour at a time.
Okay. Let's go with Fallen Decay, aka Kelmias. What is your rating / opinion of Warframe?
On a good note, it's one of those good repetitive games. But...
It's one of those good repetitive games. Is repetitive good?
Yeah. It's not always the same kind of stuff that you're doing, but it's the same.
Yeah, I gotcha.
Kind of way. It's. I can
it's
play this for a
while. But it's not a tedious repetitive.
Okay. I mean, are you a person that's against scoring? Like, are you against 1 out of 10 and that kind of stuff? Like, would you give it a score or?
In my opinion, scores don't matter because. There's games that are rated really low by people, and it's a really good game.
Yeah.
So I prefer not to score.
Okay.
But it's a really great game, in my opinion.
you definitely suggest others to play it?
Yeah, it's always fun to have others to join in and play.
Of course.
Soloing, not a good idea.
Alrighty then.
Boring. Really boring.
And you die a lot.
Okay.
Actually, no, I don't die a lot when I solo.
Well, rhinos don't count.
I'm not a rhino.
Oh, what are you?
I play mag.
Oh, okay. What's
mag? Mag doesn't count.
Mag doesn't count. Okay.
Mag doesn't count.
Flywalker, you're up next. Rating, depending on the game.
We're an expert week.
As an expert at the game, I must say, I've played with this since the unclosed beta, and I'm very impressed with what it's become in the past months. You can see the leveling system and the strengthening system has been greatly improved over the months. You see the switch from the regular skill trees, which were a little tedious, to different kinds of cards and stuff that's much easier to understand. You're also given the parkour and stuff, and you know, lots of guns. Everybody loves the guns. Different frames, different powers. A very helpful community. That's one of the most important parts of a free MMO. The most general, you want the community to be very helpful towards you and friendly. And I think that the folks at D have established a very good one. So, when I have to rate Warframe, I think I'll have to give it at least an 8 out of 10. It's not complete yet, it's still got a bunch of things to go for, but what I've seen so far, it's looking like it's going to have a pretty good future for itself, especially considering the PS4.
Alrighty then. Okay, well, now, I've played a lot of MMOs, I've played a lot of games. And I'm, by anyone who knows me knows, I'm not against rating games. However, I am against most people who do rate them, because I think they're fucking retarded. No offense to you guys, because, you know, I did ask you to rate games. Fucking retards. No, I played the game a lot in the beta, and the game has come it's very different from the very first time I played, and it's actually takes some getting used to again. Sometimes changing a game a lot after a game has already been released can be frowned upon. There's games in the past that have done that, like Star Wars Galaxies, and it blew up in their face huge. When I'm talking going from like a million or subscriptions down to getting under like 10,000. But they haven't done, you know, anything all that, like, really bad. You know, they have actually done really good improvements to the game. So those are the kind of things you got to be careful with. That said, I find the combat in the game is actually very fun. The movement style is actually very unique. You don't find that in a lot of games. And I think it's something that should be in a lot more games. The downside to the game is that there aren't a lot of mob variety. And there's not a lot of mission type variety. You end up doing a lot of the same thing over and over again. Now, you could say in every MMO you do that. You play World of Warcraft, you do one raid 15 times or more. You know, like WoW has done their last raid update until the next expansion, and that's probably going to be a year. So people are going to be doing Siege of Orgrimmar, you know, once a week or twice a week, depending on, you know, doing whatever different versions of that one raid every week. You know, that's going to be the only thing. So, you know, MMOs are repetitive, but I feel like there's a very small amount there. And it's fun while you're doing it, but it gets old fast. Now, if you can find a way to fix that, like new mission style generation or more mobs types, you know, maybe something similar to that of like Diablo, where it's completely randomly generated. Mobs have multiple abilities depending on how high or how you know, level you get.
Multiple abilities. Fuck that shit.
It still adds a more dynamic feel to it, like you're doing something different, even though it's just the illusion of content. And this game doesn't really have that. So My score for this game would probably be a 6 out of 10.
Okay.
And that's just because you run out of stuff to do so fast.
Okay, guys. We want to thank our guests today. Let's go. Fallen Decay, do you have anything you want to plug? A Facebook, Twitter, Twitch channel, anything like that?
Not really. I'm not into the media sites very much.
Okay. What about you, Buffalo? You got anything you want to plug?
Only thing I want to plug is something I had been watching on YouTube a little bit earlier, Hot Pepper Gaming. Their reviews are freaking hilarious.
Okay.
He wants to plug OJ.
Hot Pepper Gaming, pretty much what they do is they eat a spicy pepper and then review a game.
Okay. Flywalker, you got anything to plug?
I'd like to plug in my clan, Grivastek Corporation Warframe. We are a very large clan. We have a huge dojo.
I bet it's huge.
We try to go pretty hard for the different events that we have for the leaderboards and stuff, so I'd like to plug in that. Grivastek Engine.
I bet you go hard. Ahead and,
yeah, I do. You can go ahead and try to join that clan. I will be here whenever you want. If you want to come in and see what's up, just come to your boy Fly. I'll be right here.
You know,
all right, cool. And what was that website again?
That's in
the chat.
You
put it in chat.
Okay.
Another thing I want to plug is the Owned Gaming community.
Okay. Owned.so and griffistech.engine.com, GRYPHUS tech, TECH dot ENJIN.com. Draw, you plugging anything this week, dare I ask?
Well, our Twitch channels, you got Sweet Creepers, got mine, that's the one we're watching now. We got the YouTube, all the links are at the bottom of the page, just click any of those, go watch. We started a Steam community for our streaming shows. You should join it. We'll do, every time we go live, on our big shows, we'll probably post some announcements. If we do really big giveaways, we'll probably throw some announcements there. Just one of the ways to get in touch with us and play games with us more often is by joining the Steam community. That's it.
All I've got is twitch.tv/sweetcreeper. That is the hub for all things me. I'm about to finish Lego Marvel Heroes, and then from there, who knows what the fuck I'm going to play. I love to talk to you people, so come chat me. And
just
we'll
everyone beware of his cock goblin.
Beware of the cock goblin.
The cock goblin.
All right, ladies and gentlemen.
I will not take insolence.
That
will gobble your cock!
That is it for the first ever Free-to-Play Friday of Three Dudes and their Submissives. Alrighty.
Thank you all for watching. Thank you guys for guest starring, and we hope to play more stuff with you in the future. Stick around in the chat. Draw will do a giveaway since it's the first Free-to-Play Friday.
Ooh, giveaway! Appreciate it. Come on.
See you guys on Sunday.
Sunday. All right.
Sunday. We're out.
Three dudes and they're submissive.
And Saturday.
Nice.